From Careco TV, one of the longest-running outdoor programs on television today. Exploring the country and the coast in search of adventures. From the mountains of the Great Northwest to the shores of the Atlantic Ocean, this is Americana Outdoors, presented by Garmin. This week on Americana Outdoors, we're getting some insight into the challenges and triumphs that go hand in hand with turkey hunting. Throughout this episode, we'll hear some key words of wisdom for how to best increase your odds of bringing home one of these birds.
You know, turkey hunting has probably become my second favorite kind of hunting. I love whitetail, but turkey hunting is just amazing. I mean, to me, going after them when they're calling, they're vocal, you can hear them, you can move closer. That's one of my very favorite ways to hunt.
Turkeys are one of those animals that are so fun to hunt when they're gobbling and strutting and putting on that show, and you're talking to them and having a conversation about how the kids are, how's the wife, how was work, and they're answering, and everybody's just having a great time, and your adrenaline and your heartbeat's gonna go up.
It's a run and gun situation. You're just constantly going. You're moving and moving and moving and calling, and eventually one will fire off, and everything just kind of lines up, and you get the bird.
You know, turkeys really rely on their eyesight to find predators, see what's going on. And if you look at the way their head and their eyes are designed, you can tell that they're gonna spot you.
It's amazing how minute your movement can be. And those hens or those turkeys, they'll start putting and they're gone. I mean, their eyesight is second to none.
And so when you sit down and decide this is the spot I'm gonna be, you got to be camouflaged. I mean, you gotta have good camouflage, number one, but you also gotta be in some brush. I mean, you can't just have good camouflage and be out in the open.
Me personally, I love the open air hunt when we're hunting. You just kind of plop down by a tree, maybe cut some brush, build a quick brush blind, or get as far back in the shadows as I can. But, you know, I'm gonna be as covered from head to toe as I possibly can be in those situations to avoid detection by their sharp eyes. Gear for turkey hunting, I mean, to me, there's a great mix of things that you're gonna need. Obviously, a shotgun or a crossbow or a compound bow, depending on what you wanna hunt them with, will be your choices there.
Have a good turkey vest, something that got a pad to sit on and a backrest to lean against. Because when you're sitting there calling turkey, the last thing you want is to be really, really uncomfortable.
Camouflage, absolutely a must. Head to toe, top to bottom, you need to cover as much as you can in those different situations. Those are just a few things that I think are really important to gear me up to go turkey hunting. Understanding what the turkeys are saying, the noises that they make, the different calls can help you determine how to respond to them. You know, if that Tom is gobbling and cutting you off all the time, I want to be a little more aggressive with him. If he gobbles once and then never responds to anything again, you got to be a lot more patient in those situations. You've got to read all those, everything that's going on for that particular day and their mood, because every encounter is uniquely different.
One of the things that can be the most frustrating about turkey hunting is you have a bird that's firing off and it sounds like they're about 50 yards away, and then all of a sudden they go quiet.
And when they do that, it's like the most frustrating thing for a turkey hunter. So just as fun as it can be talking to them, it can sure be frustrating when you make a mistake.
You know, here's the thing about turkey hunting. You're gonna make mistakes. There's just no way around it. You hear one gobble and you're not exactly sure how far he is. You don't know exactly what the terrain is. You try to get closer and he busts you. You're gonna have all kinds of mistakes. It's hard to kill one.
It seems like when you go turkey hunting, the only times you don't make a mistake is when you get one. It seems like you're constantly making mistake after mistake because you think the bird's gonna come in a certain way and they circle around you, or you set up just a little bit wrong. There's just constantly mistakes, but that's the challenge of it.
There's so many nuances and so many fun things about it. And there's times when you gotta be patient. There's times when you can't call as much. There's times when you can call nonstop, and you just have to have the experience of time in the woods, which is great because it means you get to hunt more, to determine, you know, which way to go, which strategy to use. And still, you're gonna make mistakes. You're still gonna get busted, but that's the cool thing about it.
Coming up, we're kicking off our turkey adventures with Clark as he takes us out on a hunt that lives up to be the challenging reputation that turkeys have earned over the years. We know if you found one crappie, you may have found a thousand. We know the joy of getting your boots back in the mud. We know the journey can be more rewarding than the destination. We know the great outdoors. We love the great outdoors. Bass Pro Shops and Cabela's. Stop by today for huge savings on the gear you need and the brands you trust. Plus, free two-day shipping at BassPro.com and Cabela's.com.
How do you aim a 36-yard shot with a 30-yard fixed pin at a 15-degree angle with a 7-inch holdover without moving a single pin? Easy. You get one of these. Zero, the auto-ranging digital bow sight from Garmin.
The all-new Yamaha Wolverine X2. With a compact chassis perfect for exploring tight technical terrain, an ultra-quiet and smooth 850-class twin-cylinder engine, and next-level versatility with a 600-pound dumping cargo bed. No other side-by-side delivers this level of proven off-road performance. The all-new Wolverine X2 from Yamaha.
Americana Outdoors, presented by Garmin, is brought to you by Bass Pro Shops and Cabela's. Your adventure starts here. Garmin Zero, leave the guesswork behind. Yamaha's proven off-road ATVs and side-by-side vehicles. Welcome back to Americana Outdoors. For this hunt, Clark is taking an aggressive approach and covering as much ground as possible with the hopes of calling in a mature bird.
You know, one thing about turkey hunting is when you want to call them in, and that's what we want to do, we're just going to keep moving. We got a big place, so we can cover as much ground as we want to. And if we can find, you know, if we can find one that'll gobble, that's the one we want. That was awesome. You just never know. That was a Jake right there. So that's a year-old turkey. Got about a 4-inch beard, but not a mature bird. But I thought we had him dead to rights, and we did. We could have shot him easy, but 25 yards, that's fine. Hey, we had a great day. You know, turkey hunting is just one of those things that you're gonna have failures. I mean, that's just the way it is. One time you get too close, next time you don't get close enough. We had two great encounters with Jake's, two big ones spitting and drumming right next to us, and then we got three in. Michael thought they might be Jake's. I thought it was a Tom, but we didn't have them that good anyway. It was an awesome day. Turkey hunting, I mean, it's a rush of all time to actually get one to respond and bring him to you.
True to turkey form, the turkey have outwitted our team and lived to gobble another day. Never one to give up, Clark and Michael returned to the field the next day, this time in a location that already looks promising.
There was a couple hens come through and then some big toms come right behind them. I watched for a little bit and I end up seeing these same two hens cut across the left, and I'm thinking, that's probably where it's gonna go down. This is where the hunt gets kind of fun, because now I'm the cameraman and I gotta try to convince Clark, the hunter, what he needs to do next.
I'm still set up straight. He said, you're gonna have to move. And I'm like, I'm not doing it. And he said, Clark, you're gonna have to trust me. I said, I'm not doing it. And then I heard a little extra in his voice. I'm telling you, you're gonna move.
That was intense right there. Oh my God. We had so many turkey around us. Oh. They're gobbling. They're drumming. And Michael sees one to the left and he said he's fixing to come into the opening to the left. So what I got to do is move my gun up and get over there. And I was going to scare these, but he said, Clark, you're going to have to trust me. I trusted him. We got us a turkey. Big old beard on him. Look at that. That was awesome right there. We worked hard. I tell you what, man, we had a lot of different encounters. And that's what I love so much about turkey hunting. Especially a place like this. It's just got a lot of birds. And so even if something happens in the situation where you are, something gets messed up, well, you got a chance to go somewhere else and see if you can get another one to call. Man, that's an awesome turkey right there. Go get him to the truck and next is Michael's turn.
With a great display of teamwork to draw in the birds and set up in the perfect position, this turkey hunt is in the bag, and Clark and Michael are walking away with a great story and memory to look back on. Up next, we'll see if Michael can finish out the day with a turkey of his own, or if these toms will give him the slip.
To me, the Performance Center by Smith & Wesson means taking the best and making it better. Regardless if I'm passing on the traditions of hunting or teaching someone new about the outdoors, I know that using a Performance Center handgun will be something they will remember for the rest of their lives. Every model comes with an awesome trigger. They're reliable in all the conditions, as well as offering a variety of sight and scope mounting capabilities. The Performance Center by Smith & Wesson. Performance when it matters most.
The Thompson Center Compass 2. A feature-rich rifle packed with value and a higher standard of reliable accuracy. Now with Generation 2 trigger and threaded muzzle. Offered in scoped and non-scoped versions and in a wide variety of calibers. From the range to the fields to the mountains, TC has a rifle to match every hunter's needs. When you spray on a layer of Sawyer's Permethrin insect repellent, you've just sprayed on adventure. Sawyer, we keep you outdoors.
Americana Outdoors, presented by Garmin, is brought to you by Thompson Center, America's master gun maker. Hi-Vis Shooting Systems, see what you've been missing. Walkers, protect it or lose it. Conquest Sense, hunting sense and dog training sense. Welcome back to Americana Outdoors. To continue this early spring hunt, we'll be joining Michael on another aggressive style of turkey hunting and follow along as he and Clark cover a large area of ground to call in a mature gobbler.
All right, we've been hunting about 3 days. We've had an awesome morning. We've seen I don't know how many big turkey. Clark just got his. We got another one gobbling. We're gonna see if we can get down there real quick. It looks like it's gonna be a great morning. Turkey hunting is one of those things that is constantly challenging. It doesn't matter what day it is, where you're at. You know, this morning we heard probably 100 different gobbles. We had this one gobbling. He answered me from like 400 yards away. We walked 200 yards towards him and he quits. And you never really know what happens on that, but that's part of the fun of it. Whenever you get one to gobble back, you just gotta try it.
After that bird, there was a couple that would fire off,
but it was kind of a random fire off. They wouldn't really answer you back but every third call, so it's hard to figure out where they're at. So we decide we're just gonna keep covering ground. We're really actually getting towards the end of our hunt, and we end up going to another area on the ranch, and that's where it got good. He gobbled and gobbled, and then he quit. And I didn't even have time to get any of my other calls out. And I knew he wasn't far. Golly. Let's go look at him. I gotta go see this guy. Oh, gosh. Look at that guy. Phew. I didn't even really get to... I didn't know how big he really was. I knew he wasn't a Jake, but I know, got some nice spurs on him. Shit. That's what's fun about turkey hunting, is we have covered so much ground today. We have been busted. We've had them just completely shut off once we get 100 yards away from them. And this is literally one of the last spots we were gonna hunt today. And he gobbled, and we just kind of started walking down the road, and we hit the call again. And heck, he was coming. There was no question. Oh, man. God, that's beautiful. Phew. Let's get him back to the truck. Cleaned up. Head on. The thing about turkey hunting is it doesn't often work out, but when it does, there's no other feeling like it. We had had so many failures throughout this hunt, and it just takes about 2.5 minutes of the right bird, and he's out there strutting in front of you. You gotta call at them at the right time, they gotta answer you back, and then you have to make the right decisions on how much distance to cut. And that bird, it just worked out. There's no other way to put it. He just came running out there. He decided he wanted that hen, and we got him.
Congratulations, Michael. That's one good-looking turkey. Coming up, we're rounding out our turkey time with Wade Middleton as he joins Clark in the field and brings with him the all-new Bass Pro Shops and Cabela's Club Crystal Friction Turkey Calls.
Others decock. We do it safely. The new AccuSlide Safe Decocking System revolutionizes the crossbow market. Simply backwind the handle, stopping at any point without fear of damage, injury, or losing control. Meet the new Vengeant S440 and Viper S400 featuring the AccuSlide. Speed up to 440 feet per second, 5.8 inches wide. Its 3.5-pound zero creep trigger delivers same hole accuracy. The Vengeant S440 and Viper S400 from 10 Point.
We plan all year for this. We hone our skills. We have confidence in the gear we choose. We pore over thousands of images and videos. When the time comes, will you be ready? Introducing the all-new 4K camera by StealthCam. Proven.
Protect it or lose it.
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 Protect it
or lose it.
Protect it or lose it.
Americana Outdoors, presented by Garmin, is brought to you by 10 Point Crossbows. Perfection lives here. Record Rack, Serious Nutrition. Smith & Wesson Performance Center, performance when it matters most. Before we catch up with Wade, let's take a look at the brand new Bass Pro Shops and Cabela's Club Crystal Friction Turkey Calls.
Turkey calls come in a lot of different options. You've got your mouth calls, your box calls, and your slate calls, and each one of them require a unique set of tuning so that you can be able to maximize them. And each person probably has a little trick that they're gonna do to them, especially their mouth calls, how they're gonna trim them to fit, how they put their chalk on. But when it comes to a slate call, I think the biggest thing is you've gotta prepare it properly. I've got a Woodhaven official Cabela's Club call right here in this model right here, and you can tell it's very clean, that there's nothing's been done to that one. And then on this one here, as you look at it, it's all scratched up. It's actually the one that Clark's been using a lot on some recent hunts. And the key in preparing this is to make sure, I believe, you go in one direction with your sandpaper. You don't want to start spinning around in circles. You want to make consistent grooves there so that when you're running your striker across it, you're constantly, you know, being able to find that tune, that sound that you're looking for. And you're gonna have to scratch it often. I mean, I literally, while I'm in the field on various calls that I'm using, I'm always scratching. I'm always trying to keep it roughed up because that's what your striker is sliding across to help make all the different calls and the sounds that you're looking at. So always keep that in mind. Keep it tuned up, drag it slowly, softly across it, get it roughed up again, you'll be good to go. One final thing, try to avoid touching it. It's absolutely impossible not to touch it a little bit. You're gonna get some dirt on there, but that dirt and the oil from your hands, anything that you're touching and putting on there, it's gonna get in those grooves and it's gonna affect the call sound a little bit. So give it a try, tune up those slate calls. You're gonna find great usage, especially when you're trying to get them up close, get those birds to finish a lot of times. It's what I use more often than not when I'm turkey hunting. You know, turkey hunting to me is about the encounter. I love the interaction that you have with the hens where you're communicating with them. I love seeing the tom strut. I love to hear them gobble and then just watch their movements. And I think over the last 15 or 20 years, every year that I do it, number one, the more I realize what I don't know, and I can be so humbled by them, but number two, the more excited I get when I set out early morning and you're hearing the birds wake up and you hear the first yelps and some gobbles, and it just never gets old.
I say the first one. Yeah, long-bearded, he's strutting. Bunch of toms.
Two of them.
That's what I thought.
He's right there. I think he's dead.
He's dead.
Goes down quick sometimes, doesn't it? It's been a hard season for me, so I went ahead and got two at one time.
That was awesome.
Oh, man. We get pretty fired up about these turkeys gosh, when we get chance to go.
You know, Wade, a lot of times we're fishing this time of year, but it's getting out in the woods, it's so green, so pretty this time of year, and hearing a few gobble, knowing they're coming to you, that's awesome.
When they're talking and strutting and putting on a show, it's about as fun as anything I can find. But
yeah, and I mean, a lot of times you that one hen or something will come in there and it'll putt just a little bit, and you know that it's a little bit nervous, and you calmed them down several times this time.
And you know, and I think there's guys good with slate calls, there's guys good with mouth, the box. I mean, it's just kind of a mix. Everybody does it a little different.
Everybody does it different. What I've learned is you just got to get out there and do it. And I mean, they make sounds,
all kinds of different sounds.
And calls sound so different, you know. That's the cool thing about a glass call is when you get that glass call, you can make different sounds with it. Turn the striker just a little bit, move the call just a little bit, turn it around, work it with sandpaper, and it'll make you a whole different call.
And I try to mimic what they're doing. That's what I tell people. Have a conversation with them.
Yeah.
Ask them how the wife is. Ask them how the kids are. Talk to them and calm them down. And if you can get the hens talking, you never know. So pretty good.
That's
pretty
awesome.
Fun.
That's awesome.
Congrats, Wade, for this exciting first-time experience of getting two turkeys at once. Some of the key takeaways from today's show are that a turkey's eyesight is its greatest defense, with its hearing coming in at a close second. When you hit the field for your next turkey hunt, keep in mind that while mistakes can and will happen, if you keep at it and outsmart the bird, you'll walk away with some great encounters and hopefully a beautiful turkey for the table. Hey, thank you for watching, and join us next week on a new episode of Americana Outdoors. Americana Outdoors is a Careco TV production.
We demand a lot from the products that we use on our adventures around the world. When it comes to keeping things seriously cold, we rely on Angle Coolers, who have for over 50 years kept things cold. Angle Coolers, the original high-performance cooler.
To know why the top shooting pros choose Hi-Viz? Hi-Viz has an enormous lineup of sights for every shooting platform possible that are clean looking and easy to mount. Improve your shooting with faster target acquisition and eliminate cross-eyed dominance. Hi-Viz sights are the brightest out there, helping you find your target with ease no matter the shooting conditions. Choose the best. Choose Hi-Viz and see what you've been missing.
What does it take to make Evercom deer scent? It takes a deer farmer who raises whitetails. It takes mixing the special blend of Evercom, testing each batch.
Smells like deer.
And then pouring each container. Each container is cleaned, examined, and packaged for shipping. It takes the finest deer herd and a great team of people to make the best hunting scent available. Evercom, from Conquest Scents.